नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 7, कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू दैट हॉर्मोन्स इन द एनिमल्स। सो यू नो दैट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एड्रेनल ग्लैंड्स। ओके, adrenal glands. So this adrenal, so you know that adrenal glands releases adrenaline hormones, adrenaline. But today we discuss other hormones. Let us examine some examples to understand. How hormones help in coordinated growth. Regulating and coordinating the growth. Okay. So we have seen that salt packets. You have seen that the salt packets enriched with the iodine. See, salt packets which say iodized salt, which you are saying iodized salt in our diet. See, this salt is enriched, rich with the iodine. So this reason is rich with the iodine. Iodine is there, okay, rich with the iodine. So dear students, now the question arises, why is it important for us to have iodized salt in our diet? Why it is so important in our diet or in our food? So the answer is, iodine is necessary for the thyroid gland. See, iodine is necessary for the thyroid gland to make thyroxine hormone. See, to make it, this is one more hormone, thyroxine hormone. For the production of the thyroxine hormone, so iodine is required. Okay? Very important question. This thyroxine, the function is what? What is thyroxine function? Thyroxine regulates carbohydrates, protein, and fat. See, thyroxine is regulating the carbohydrate, fats, and as well as which one? Proteins. Okay. Protein. This regulates the which one? Carbohydrates, protein, and fats metabolism for the chemical reaction in the body. So it provides the best balance for the body. So this is best balance. Okay. This is giving the best balance for the growth. So that is why iodine is so essential. Okay, dear students. Okay, in case iodine is deficient, then in our diet there is a possibility that we might suffer from goiter, G-O-I-T-R, goiter. So then you may suffer from the goiter. Okay, what is goiter? So one of the symptoms of the goiter is the swollen neck. So what is the symptom of this swollen neck? Swollen neck. Correct? For the neck part that is swollen, swelling. Okay? That part is comes out. So that is why these are the what requirement of the iodine. So that is why iodized salt is so essential in our diet. And at the same time, thyroid gland for the production of the thyroxine hormone is so essential. Okay, dear students. Now the next paragraph. Sometimes we come across people who are either very short. See, sometimes you will come, you are knowing that the people are very short or very long. See, sometimes you are knowing that people are very short or maybe very long also. See, very short or very long. See, very short or very long. See, now look here now. Sometimes the people we come across who are either very short, that we are saying very short means dwarf, D-W-A-R. This is the word we are using. Dwarf people. And extremely tall also. G-I-A-N-T-S. Very long. G-I-A-N-T-S. Giants. So very long people, white, have you ever wondered how this happens, how it may be happening? So dear students, this is because of growth hormone is one of the hormones secreted by the pituitary glands. See, growth hormone is essential, responsible is growth hormone. This is secreted by the pituitary gland. Okay? So this one. So, very tall and very short is the reason of growth hormone. The pituitary gland is secreting. Okay? So, pituitary gland is also called as muscle gland. So what you are saying? Muscle gland, because this functions is so much, it is what you are saying, regulating many of the active activities or functions in our bodies. So that is why pituitary gland is also called as muscle gland. Okay, remember students, underlined also. Okay, now, as is the name indicates, growth hormone regulates the growth and development of the body. The name itself indicates in the growth hormone, these are regulating the growth aspect. Growth hormone regulates growth and development of our body. If there is a deficiency, deficiency means lacking. If there is a deficiency of this hormone in the childhood, then it leads to the, what you are saying, dwarfism. Okay. Or if it is sometimes more releasing, so see, sometimes if it is releasing so less, then dwarfism. If it releases so much, then the is what you are saying, giants. So that is why it has to release in the, what you are saying, the precise manner, the exact manner, so that height can be maintained, reasonable height will be there. Okay, this is about the pituitary gland or about growth hormone. Okay, now we will see that you must have noticed that many dramatic changes. See, dear students, one more hormone we will study now. See, what hormones? Some hormones, you know, of dramatic changes is given. Sometimes dramatic changes means, so you know that in your level now, at the age of 12 to 13 or 10 to hear given book, 10 to 13 years of age. These ages are associated with puberty. See, puberty age we are saying. Puberty. P-U-B-E-R-T-Y. They mean this, the person is capable of first producing or sexual, able to do the sexual reproduction. So that is what we are saying, the puberty. Okay, during this age, 10 to 12 or 13 years age, you see that mustache is coming, beard is coming, and height is growing, and chest is expanding. So like this, these are the symptoms indicating that the person is capable of sexual reproduction or the growth. Okay, because of the reason, secretion of the testosterone in the males. See, the hormones. Testo your own, producing the what? Gland is testis in the male. See, testosterone, 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 the testes in the male, and female is estrogen. Estrogen is O-E-S-T-R-O-G-E-N, estrogen in the female. Okay, this is the female gland, female in the ovary, that's in what? Ovary produces the test, what? Estrogen. See, ovary is the producers estrogen. And in the male, testis produces testosterone. In the female, ovary produces estrogen. So these are the hormones. Okay. So these are the hormones indicating the person is capable of sexual reproduction. Okay. So like this, these hormones also you study. Okay. Now we'll go for next one. Do you know anyone in your family? Okay, next one. Do you know that anyone in your family is or friends who has been advised by the doctor to take less sugar in their diet? See, sometimes you know that whenever persons are saying the less sugar you have to take less. The person, doctors are advising, take sugar less. Why? So, dear students, because they are suffering from the diabetes. They are suffering from the diabetes, D-I-A-B-E-T-S, diabetes. So, diabetes disease. Okay. So, as a treatment, the doctors are suggesting or they might be taking injections of insulin. So what they are doing? They are providing the insulin. So this is a hormone. This one is hormone. Hormone. Another kind of hormone, insulin. Okay. That is given by injections. Okay. This is a hormone. This insulin is a hormone. This hormone is produced by the pancreas. See, where it is producing? Pancreas. So, you know that pancreas are also releasing the digestive juices for the digestion. And at the same time, pancreas also releases hormones also. Okay? So, this is both endocrine and exocrine glands. It is acting or supplying for the body whatever the requirements. And this which is produced by the pancreas and helping regulating the blood sugar levels. So this one insulin is helping blood sugar levels. Okay, blood sugar levels. Okay, this is also a insulin, also a hormone. If it is not secreted in the proper amounts, see, this insulin is not secreted in our body at the proper amount, the sugar level in the blood rises and causing many of the harmful effects. So that is why persons are suffering the diabetes. If it is releases more or if it is releases less, then the doctors are prescribing the insulin. Okay, dear students. Now we will see that last paragraph. If it is so important that hormones should be secreted in precise quantities. So that's why hormones should release in the precise, the exact, the required quantities. We need a mechanism through which this is done. So for this, we need a mechanism for that. It should be done. The timing and the amount of the hormone. See, dear students, now here you have to listen that the timing, say at the time it is required and at the same time the amount of the hormone released and regulated by the feedback mechanisms. So this is very important asking by the feedback. This feedback mechanism is so essential for our body. So this one is taking care for us. This feedback mechanism, amount of hormone, timing, and as well as releasing regulated by the feedback mechanisms. So underlined here, feedback mechanisms. For example, okay, how it will be acting or regulating? If the sugar levels in the blood rises, suppose you think if the sugar level is rises, then they are detected by the cells of the pancreas. The cells of the pancreas are detecting, which respond by producing the more insulin. So then they are responding to produce the more insulin. Or as the blood sugar level falls, suppose if the blood sugar level is falls, decreases, then this insulin secretion is also reduced. So this is the work of which one? Work of feed mechanism. Okay, underline the feed mechanism. So dear students, we have completed hormones and various hormones and where they are producing and what is the role of the hormone. Okay, this all read as well as write also. Okay, we have completed this lesson and go through this lesson, read it properly. In any difficulty, ask to me also. Okay? Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for joining us.